Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Caesar salad burgers. And the reason I chose to make these today is that we did Caesar salad recently and I have a lot of romaine lettuce left over and I wanted to use it somehow. And this is a very interesting recipe that I think you'll enjoy. And I thought some of you might be in the same situation. You made your Caesar salad and then you've got this lettuce that you're going to have to eat in salads and stuff like that. You don't have to eat it in salad only. You can make Caesar salad burgers. So right here I have my hamburger, or this is actually lean ground beef. It's 4% fat. So when I fry the hamburgers, which I'm going to do over here on the stove, I'm going to add in some oil there. Actually, I'll tell you right now, I've got some extra virgin olive oil and I've already put 1 1/2 tablespoons, just enough to coat the bottom well, and that will help these burgers, which are not very fat at all, to be able to fry properly. All right, so I guess we need to mix up our sauce, because it really is nice to have a little bit of time for it to sit in the refrigerator so that it can have all those flavors blend together. Now this is a different recipe for a sauce, and you can use it as a Caesar salad dressing in place of the other one that I gave you, but it's quite a bit like it. It just has a few variations. We're starting with 1/2 cup of mayonnaise, and this is free mayo, which is fat-free. That's just to help out on the fat calories and the fat. But you all need to start with your mayonnaise. And then we use mustard. And I've chosen to use 1 tablespoon of Herlocher's dipping mustard. I just really like the flavor of it, and we have plenty of sort of sour things and salty things to balance off the sweetness of this mustard, and this is going to give it a really good flavor. But I know some of you have had trouble finding this because I use it as a dipping mustard for a couple of things that I made earlier. So if you have something like this, French's honey mustard, or if you have a dark mustard, if you have a brown mustard, any of those types of prepared mustard would be fine. Just 1 tablespoon of the mustard. Then someone asked me with regard to the Caesar salad if they could use the jarred variety of garlic, because I understand that if you don't have fresh garlic all the time, it's really convenient to keep this in a jar, and I keep mine in my freezer, and then if I need some, I will stick it in the microwave enough to get some out, or I'll just take a fork and scrape until I get what I need. So you need about 2 cloves of minced garlic. Use fresh if you like, but I'm using a couple of what I would say are cloves that come from this jarred chopped garlic. So your choice on that, but I just wanted to answer that question and kind of demonstrate that it will work. Lemon juice, you'll need 1 tablespoon of lemon juice, and now you begin to see the balance of that sweet dipping mustard. And also coming along next, we have hot sauce. 1/4 teaspoon of hot sauce, or you can just use a couple of dashes if you want to, but that gives it a little zip. And then we have Worcestershire sauce, so that's going to give it some saltiness and some tanginess and flavor. So it's really a marvelous blend that we're putting together here, and I think you'll really enjoy it. I have one more item that I'm going to add to this blend, and this is freshly ground black pepper. So if you have some black peppercorns that you'd like to grind just to taste, do that, or you can use just regular ground black pepper that you might use on your table. So when we get all these together, we want them blended, and we want them very well blended. So I'm going to use this hand blender. So this is what your Caesar dressing looks like when you have it blended. Now this will be complete when I add a couple of tablespoons of finely shredded Parmesan cheese. And then it's pretty important to let this sit for a bit in order to get those flavors to combine. So I'm going to be covering this with plastic wrap and placing it in the refrigerator. So I'll be right back to do the hamburgers. Now we're going to make our burgers. What I've done with this 1 pound of ground beef is I have used some meat tenderizer. This is Adolph's meat tenderizer, no MSG. I've done that on one side, and I've used freshly ground black pepper on that side. And I've already turned it over so I can wash my hands and come back. So this side needs to be sprinkled a little bit. You would want the equivalent of the salt that you would put in. For 1 pound of ground beef, you put in about 1 teaspoon of salt, so just the equivalent. And then to your taste on the ground black pepper. I'm going 1/3 of the way in on this end, and then another third so that they all look equally sized. Then let me just take one of them and show you what I do. I want to really work in that meat tenderizer and the ground peppercorns, and this will make a nice, generous burger. And what I'd like to do is keep it flat on one side, and then on the other side, if I can make sort of an indentation, and if I can sort of make that hold throughout the cooking, I don't know if I can really, but that will make a really nice bowl to hold the Caesar dressing that we have, and it will really help a little bit. And what I'm going to do is come over here. This is not quite heated. I'm going to turn it up a little bit. But when it will sizzle, when I put this in, that means it's at the temperature that I want, and then from there I might want to turn it to medium or even low, because you don't want it popping and spattering everywhere. So I'm going to go ahead and put this in. It may not be as hot as I normally would use, but I think that's fine. So I will probably take a spoon and keep pressing to make that indentation. If it doesn't work out, it's not a big problem. You just spread your seasoned dressing on the top of it, and it's just like mayonnaise or ketchup or mustard or anything else. It's just, I'd like to get more of it in there if possible. So I'll take care of shaping these and frying them, and I'll get back to you with our burgers. These burgers look like they're done. Now, everybody likes their burgers done to their own taste, and I'm just doing these the way Rick and I like them. But you can see, for instance, this is one that I'm going to turn it over to show you. Here is the indentation that I made. So that's going to hold some of that Caesar dressing. And each one of these has a similar indentation. So I've turned up the stove, and I'm putting these on paper toweling to drain. And then we'll make them up into sandwiches. They will be our Caesar salad hamburgers. I think that's going to be okay. So let's come over here, and I'm going to pat these off just a little bit, get any of that grease that has collected up in those centers, get that soaked up with the paper towel. And then I will just choose one of these, and I have my buns here that I am going to use, and these just came from the deli section of my grocery store. And when you get them, these actually say that they are sesame Kaiser rolls. And there were, I think, 6 in the package, and they come like this. So what you need to do is to take a knife and split them into 2 fairly equal parts. And I've done that and brought it down here to our serving plate. So I'm going to open up the 2 halves, and then I'll place one of these. Let me just use this fork that I have out. One of these, this nice looking one here. What goes next is your Caesar salad dressing. So let's just bring out as much as you like. And that's the reason for that little cavity right there. You'll be able to put at least a good tablespoon's worth into there. And then here's where the romaine lettuce comes in. You want to go to the heart, and I had all this left over from my salad, actually. But these little tender pieces are the best. If you only have the outside pieces, that's okay too. I would snap off anything that looks like it's going to be tough. And then place these over your Caesar salad dressing. Then you're going to take your leftover Parmesan cheese that's shredded. We had a little extra that we didn't put into the mix, about a tablespoon or so per burger, and then a little shake of black pepper. If you want to grind it freshly, that's fine, or just from the table like this. So we put the top on, and there we have our Caesar salad burger. I think you're going to enjoy this one, and maybe it will help you have a use for any romaine lettuce that you might have left over from your Caesar salad.